Hello students, today we are going to discuss a very interesting topic, that is consumer awareness. The subtopics under the chapter are meaning of consumer awareness, forms of consumer exploitation, reasons for the exploitation of the consumers, rights that the consumer has, COPRA 1986, duties of a consumer, food adulteration and right to information. Before moving ahead, I would like to clear what exactly is meant by a consumer. Consumer is a market participant who purchases goods and services by paying a price to derive utility. A consumer, a rational consumer, is going to purchase any commodity or a service only when he receives some form of a satisfaction from the product, irrespective of the price. We see many consumers, they purchase expensive products which are generally the brands, okay? For example, it could be Reebok, Nike, Zara, etc. We often think, why are these consumers ready to pay such a high price for the same product which is available elsewhere at a very low cost or low price? The reason being here is that the satisfaction which the consumer is gaining from using the expensive product is very high. And at that time, he does not care about what price the product offers. And therefore, a consumer, a rational consumer, before making a decision, will look at two things. First will be whether the product has some utility or not. And the next thing will be the price of the product. With the advancement of technology, it has become very easier for the consumer to directly communicate with the seller. But this was not the case, say somewhere around 4 or 5 decades ago. So there were a lot of happenings in the market which led to the exploitation of the consumer. So here we are to exactly understand what is the position of a consumer in the market, what are the activities which are taking place in the market, and how it affects the consumer, and what are the things as a consumer the person should know, and what are the steps he can take in case he faces any kind of malpractices on the part of the producer or the seller. So let us understand what consumer awareness is. Consumer consciousness towards his or her rights and duties is known as consumer awareness. This in simpler terms means that a consumer should have the knowledge, should have the sufficient information as to what measures he can take in case he faces any grievances in the market, or what are his duties he needs to perform so as to ensure free and transparent exchange of commodities and services in the market. Earlier it was quite difficult, but today we have lot of advertisements, we have lot of information on the internet portal. So now it has become an easy task for everybody to share their rights, to share, understand their duties, at the same time to share information with respect to various products. Now let us see what were the malpractices or what were the unscrupulous activities which the sellers or the producers they used to perform which led to exploitation of the consumer. First is underweight and undermeasurement. Many goods in the market have a particular description of a certain weight, but when the consumer uses the product, he comes to know that it was underweighted or undermeasured. Means the scales which are being used by the sellers and the producers are manipulative, and they sell lesser quantity to the consumer as to what is shown in the product. Next is substandard quality. Many products in the market are sold at a quality different from that given in the description. For example, many medicines or many products are sold beyond the expiry date, or the many products are sold in a condition which is defective. So such goods are termed to be a substandard quality. Next is duplicate articles. Many market participants, they create fake products under the name of some genuine logo or a company or a brand. So when the consumers purchase these products under a presumption that they belong to the original brand, so such articles are termed to be as duplicate articles. These participants, they purposely do it to induce the customer and to deceive them for buying the products. Next is lack of safety devices. Earlier, I would not say today, but earlier definitely the products which were being sold to the consumer did not have sufficient instruction about its use, especially in case of electronic devices, which made consumers use them without any process or any particular procedure, and they ended up having electric shocks or some other form of injury to them. Even there was no specific instruction about keeping the electronic devices away from the children. So there were many cases listed under this wherein the consumer had suffered or even lost their lives. So later, we then made an important right under this, that is right to safety, which makes it essential for all the sellers and the producers to specify clearly the instructions of use of the product and the age group which can have access to the product. Next is artificial scarcity. Scarcity means shortage of certain goods and services in the market, wherein the demand is higher and the supply may be less. But many a times, the sellers and the producers, they purposely create the scarcity in the market, which is called as artificial scarcity, so as to ensure they end up earning higher prices for the products, because we've already discussed in economics that when the demand is higher and the supply is less, consumers are ready to pay higher prices for the product. And that is the reason the sellers create artificial scarcity, which is unethical and illegal, which in general terms is also known as hoarding and black marketing. Next is poor after-sale service. Once the consumer purchases a good and then later he has any problem, he will contact a customer care or he will approach the seller himself. But often after the product is sold, the behavior of the seller changes towards the consumer. Either they refuse to provide any kind of an after-sale service, or even they don't bother to listen to the grievance of the consumer. Next is adulteration and impurity. Adulteration is a process wherein certain goods and services are made impure by adding harmful substances to it or adding other substances in order to increase the quantity. That we are going to discuss in brief in the subsequent subpart. Next is rude behavior. The behavior of the sellers and producers in the market is not appropriate. That is, it makes the communication between the consumer and the seller and the producer very difficult, and which is against the market ethics. Next topic is reasons for consumer exploitation. Now, why is it possible for the sellers and the producers to do all of these kind of mischiefs? The reason being is lack of information. Since the consumers are diversified and they are into different geographical location, and the seller can easily perform these kind of activities with each and every one. And since there was earlier no unified platform wherein the consumers can express each other's problems or disputes or grievances, it was easier for sellers to do them. But today, because of the technology and thanks to them, we have a platform wherein within a fraction of seconds, we could share the problem we faced with a particular product or the behavior of the other participant. Next is shortage of goods and services. Earlier, a particular product did not have much of the variety or producers selling them, and there were always a shortage of such goods and services. So instead of complaining, it was a need of the consumer, so they had to purchase it in whatever condition or whatever way it was provided to them. Next is limited competition. Earlier, since there were not much producers and there was no competition, nobody was present to point out the loopholes, to point out the lacunae in the product of the other. But today, since there are so many producers, they always come up with the problems in the product of the competitor and how his product is better than that of the others. So this leads to production of better quality of the products to win the competition and to earn higher profits. Next is illiteracy. Consumers are not well aware about their rights or not well aware about the activities that are taking place in the markets. Therefore, because of illiteracy, they were not able to prevent such exploitation. Next is ill effects of advertisement. Advertisements are one of the biggest attraction for the customers because they generally glorify the product in the advertisement and make it very attractive. That lures the consumer and they end up buying the product. For example, Fair and Lovely. So that shows that if you use it or you apply for a certain period, you become fair enough. But if you see in reality, no cream is available that can change the color of your skin, and that has ill effect, and therefore it is a kind of an exploitative activity of deceiving the customers and making them buy your products and increasing your sales. Now coming to consumer rights. So under what rights can a consumer complain and can seek a remedy? First is right to safety. Right to safety is every person has a right to live, and it cannot allow any Tom, Dick and Harry to just come create a product and affect its health, especially when we deal with food and we deal with electronic devices. So herein the instructions as to how one should use the product, also what are the effects of using the product and what are the constituents while making the product is all available and listed on the product. So this helps the consumer to decide whether he wants to use it and whether he does not want to. Next is right to be informed. Earlier the product did not have well packaged material, right? The labeling was not good enough. But today every product has proper packaging and labeling, also mentioning the date of manufacture, the date of expiry, the price, what are the ingredients used while making the products, other instructions, the name of the company, the customer care, the address, the phone number. So all of these information have been provided under the second right that we have, that is right to be informed. So when I am using a product or a service, it is essential for me to know each and everything about it. Next is right to choose. Earlier this was not exercised well enough because we mentioned that the number of producers were limited in the market, so we had to purchase or avail whatever was available. But today, since there are a lot of competition and competitors in the market, you could choose any brand, any product, and nobody can stop you from doing that. Next is right to be heard. When any manipulative activity has been performed to you by the sellers and the producer or any other market participant, there are forums wherein you could approach and you could file a complaint. So this is right to be heard. Next is right to seek redressal. Not only do you have a right to be heard, that is right to place a complaint, but also it is the responsibility of the forum that if your case is genuine, then you should be provided with a remedy. The remedy could be either replacement of the product and the service, or either it could be compensation for the damages if you faced any, or it could be compensation for using the particular product and the mental agony you have been facing throughout the complaint process, the procedure. And if the repercussions of using that product has been very severe, then you could request the forum to cancel or suspend the license, and several other remedies which are available. Next is right to education. You've seen there are various posters in the television or in the newspaper stating Jago Grahak Jago, or you see many actors, they're creating short films showing that what kind of information the consumer should have, and it's a responsibility of the consumer to be up to date with the changes taking place in the market and with respect to the changes in the product and any other grievances which if any other consumer is facing. So that product must be well analyzed before using. Next is duties of the consumer. It's not always that things can be taken care by the forum only on the part of sellers as well as the producers. There are certain responsibilities and the duties on the part of consumer also that he needs to perform is to ensure that the exploitation does not take place. First is proper inspection at the time of purchase. If you are willing to purchase a product, make sure that all the sufficient information is mentioned, the price is appropriate, the quality of the product is what you have been seeing in the advertisement or what the seller has displayed to you. Next is cash memo and warranty card. You should always demand for a cash memo as it acts as a proof and evidence for the purchase you've made. And in case if you want to avail any after sale services, you can use that evidence to show it to the seller, against which he cannot deny providing you an service. And a warranty card, that is if you're using a product and if it has any issue later, so under that warranty period you could get it rectified. And if you don't have that card, the seller can easily deny of you cross the warranty period or the product not having any warranty as such. Next is aware about the rights which we've discussed. should be known to each and every consumer to protect himself and his interest. Next is must have knowledge of method of complaint. How should you complain about the problem or your dispute with the seller and producer, and whom should you approach, and what are the remedies available? All these are knowledges which a consumer should have. And form consumer protection groups and organizations. Whenever you feel a consumer is suffering or there has been an issue, it should be a moral responsibility for every person to form groups and organizations and support the consumer. Also, not only filing complaints, but these organizations should also be created to spread awareness about the products and about the market or any changes which we believe will make us unified and make us strong against the sellers and producers. Next is food adulteration. Food adulteration is merely the way of altering the composition of food items in such a manner that it loses the nutritional value. We eat a commodity or we consume a commodity because it offers some nutritional value to us. But when you find that the quantity or the quality has been degraded by adding some harmful substances or some kind of a substance that changes its composition, that is definitely going to hurt not only in terms of our health but also make us feel betrayed and deceived. So that is the reason this food adulteration needs to be prevented by understanding what exactly it is. You see, various milk products are adulterated or made impure by adding water to it. You see, the fats and the oils are also adulterated by adding some harmful substances to it. Many a times you see it in case of food grains. When you see the product in the display, it's very pure and clean. But when you buy it, you see that there are a lot of stones put in the grains. That is just done purposely to increase the quantity and make it impure. So all of these activities are considered to be food adulteration, which leads to degrading the value of the commodity and adding unnecessary and harmful substances to it. Because of all these practices in the market, the consumers were very, very aggrieved. And somewhere around in 1980s, lot many consumers came together and they started fighting for their rights. And understanding their grievances and problems, the parliament, the legislature, they enacted a law which was Consumer Protection Act 1986. This act ensures that no further manipulative activities can be conducted by the sellers and the producers that harm the consumer, and also has given us lot of information and awareness along with the rights and duties that we need to perform. It covers all the sector, that is, the seller cannot deny that he is not covered under this act. It covers all the sector, public, private, joint, etc. It applies to all kinds of goods and services, so there is no restriction on the variety. Next is three-tier system. Whenever you have a complaint, you can file it under the act. There are three forums available, that is district consumer redressal forum, state redressal forum and national redressal forum. Depending upon the amount in question and the dispute and the level of grievance, you can approach either of them. That is, first you could approach the district forum, and if you're not satisfied enough with the decision, you could move to the state forum and then national forum subsequently. Next is seek quick remedies against the malpractice. Most of the times you don't need to even wait for filing a complaint. Even providing the grievances to the sellers and the consumer and even telling that you're aware of the right will provide you quick remedies, as they also know if they are in a position of being unethical, they will easily provide a remedy to you. So hence we conclude that the consumers are today in a more strong position compared to what they were earlier, and it is very essential for each and every person, not only the ones who are willing to but also who are not aware, to know what are their rights and duties and spread awareness throughout the country, throughout the geographical location, as to make us more unified and robust. So here I conclude the chapter, and I would like to thank you all for great and overwhelming response for the previous video. And do like, share and subscribe to our channel for more such videos. And if you have any doubt with respect to the topic, you can mention it in the comments. Thank you.